Welcome. Welcome to Ethiopia.
4 years ago, DSM started its partnership with the World Food Programme of the United Nations. Why? Because DSM is the world's largest micronutrition provider. Products like vitamins and minerals. But we also want to make a difference for those people who cannot take care of themselves. 3 years ago, I traveled to Bangladesh and I could see with my own eyes what DSM is doing. And I could see with my own eyes how much our help is needed over there. DSM's help is not only providing money. It's not only providing technological assistance, sharing our know-how, sharing our technologies. No, it is also delivering products and even developing new products. We have, especially for the World Food Programme of the United Nations, developed new products like the Mix Me sachets to allow mothers to sprinkle nutritional supplements over the food of their children. Ethiopia is a country where the World Food Programme of the United Nations is very active. Ethiopia. It's most likely the birthplace of our civilization. It's most likely where mankind started. And in this country, so rich of history, is struggling at this moment with poverty, is struggling with the impact of refugees coming from Sudan, Somalia, is struggling with diseases like AIDS. Ethiopia is located in Eastern Africa, bordering Somalia in the east, Kenya in the south, and Sudan in the west. There are almost 80 million people in Ethiopia, and the World Food Programme provides to nearly 10 million people every day their meal. A poor country. The average daily income is just reaching $4 a day. Can you imagine? Most people in Ethiopia are farmers. They're growing some crops or having a few cows. The houses of most people in Ethiopia are very simple wooden constructions with some plastic bags, some other materials. Inside those wooden huts, if I would call them, it's dark. There's no water, there's no electricity. Mamma mia, realize what a good life we have. Visiting the refugee camps made an everlasting impression on myself and I think also of the other people traveling together with me. We flew from Addis Ababa to the east, to Jijiga, and there took a car and arriving to the refugee camp close to the border with Somalia, full of Somalian refugees. Escaping Somalia, where civil war is happening at this moment. People leaving everything behind, having nothing. Not being able to return to Somalia. Of course, that is what most of the people would like. Not being able to set up their own business or their own living in Ethiopia, because the country is very poor and already struggling with the lives of the Ethiopians themselves. Waiting and sitting there and hoping for a better future. For them, and for the children. Ethiopia provided the land. It's a kind of desert, dry area. And the United Nations and the World Food Programme took care that those people can live somewhere. Again, in the huts I described before, in tents, 10,000 together. Every day, the World Food Programme is taking care they get something to eat. And hopefully, with the help of DSM, we can take care it is enriched. And the children of those refugees get not a real setback already early in their life. So what a future, uncertain, unclear. What struck me quite a bit is the kids in the refugee camp. When we visited, we made fun with them. They wanted to touch our skins. They want to talk with us. They want to do high fives. They want to play with us. Kids making jokes. But you see in the eyes of their parents their concerns. You see in the eyes of the parents, what kind of future will my kids have? Where do we go to? People immediately coming to us, talking, asking, can we help them further? Can we bring them a brighter life? Yeah, That is our slogan, Bright Science, Brighter Living. We help the kids, we help the parents with the daily need of food. We take care indeed that the kids will not have a setback in the early years of their life. But the real future of those people is uncertain. After a couple of hours, and having discussed in depth with the refugees how we can further improve our help and the contribution of WFP, we left and drove on. They stayed there behind, waiting, hoping on a better future. I still hope we are contributing to that. I think we do. From the camp, we drove further into the country and we went more north to Daira Dawa. We were driving through the woods, we were driving through a valley. After quite a while driving, we entered indeed a big area where a school was, a big school even, with more than 1,250 students, kids, being on school, sent by their parents. Why? Because the school is providing food three times a day. Children come from the area around the school. For some of those kids, it's an hour, 1.5 hour walking early morning on an empty stomach to enter the school to get your first meal. During the day, they get the second meal, and before they leave, they get the third meal. And the nice thing is, since they are in school, they learn something. A next generation who's better educated, better fed than their parents. I think this is the only way to build the society, to take care that the next generation is more able to shape their future than the previous generation. Last, we visit the so-called merit program. Also very impressive. Degraded areas of land where small farmers every time was trying to get the maximum of their land. And then the World Food Program, the United Nations said, okay, we provide you food if you help to develop your own area. For 3 years they got food from the United Nations and now they have a beautiful area where they can take care of their own future. Work for food. They need to invest in their own future and then they get the help of the United Nations. I think it's the right way to do and to take care that they can shape their own future.
A company like ours, DSM, has the ability to help people. Of course, we are business. Of course, we have shareholders. Of course, we need to take care of our company. But our company needs also to take care of the world. And I'm proud on all the people of DSM that we are contributing to that.
The help DSM is giving to the United Nations and WFP is with food, is with micronutrition, vitamins. But I'm glad to see also that we can provide more help, also from the materials area. Composite resins, or maybe other lightweight materials, cheap materials, that we can use for making huts, for making houses, and all kinds of other options which are there. And I'm convinced that also from our materials area, we can contribute more to the development of those countries. And I'm proud that DSM is not turning its back, but providing the help. And I hope that many other companies will do the same, because only via collaboration between the public and the private sector, we can address those problems. Impressive trip to Ethiopia, where I could see that our bright science can provide a brighter living.
And you can help too by supporting a new initiative of WFP. The initiative is called We Feed Back. And you can donate some money of your food, what you take, maybe your favorite food, and you skip that once in a while, and you donate that amount of money to WFP. And please visit the site of this new initiative of WFP, wefeedback.org. wefeedback.org.